Hi, this is Joel Persinger. I'm the Gun Guy. Thank you very much for all of your support on Gun Guy TV and for watching the videos and all the other great stuff that you do. I do want to let you know we're not prisoners of YouTube. We are on a bunch of other platforms as well. So I urge you to check out one of these other platforms and make sure you subscribe or follow there in case something happens to us on YouTube. You'll know where we are. Now, this particular video I'm doing from Yuma at Sprague's Sports. Sprague Sports is a gigantic gun store and range right in the heart of Yuma. I stop here often whenever I come out to go to the Adair range to shoot or happen to be driving down I-8 and come through Yuma. I generally stop and get lunch and I'll come over here to Sprague's. When you're from California, this place is like walking through you're like a kid in a candy store. I mean, there's just such a great a store full of all kinds of guns and gear and other stuff. And one of the guns that is not available in California that I'm reviewing today, and it's the first one coming here to Sprague's, is the Honor Guard pistol from Honor Defense. I took it out on the range and I fired it a lot today on the indoor range. I put a variety of ammunition through it. I shot, I think on the first target, I shot nothing but Tula steel case cheapy range ammo. I wanted to see if it would function well with the steel case ammo, and it ran like a Swiss watch the whole time. And then on the second target, that was just standard blazer range ammo that was brass case ammo, and it ran that without any problem at all. And then I thought, well, let's put some defensive ammo through it. So I went out here on Sprague's, and one of the nice things about Sprague's is, unlike California, you just walk over and get the ammo and take it to the counter. You know, it's kind of like a foreign experience to me because I gotta wait for the clerk to come get it in California. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, I went and picked up some Federal Premium hollow points and ran that through the gun on the third target. I found the hollow points shot a little bit higher. But again, that's getting used to whatever ammo you're carrying in the gun. But I'll tell you, it functioned flawlessly the entire time. I didn't have a single hiccup or miss or whatever, and I put several hundred rounds through the gun today, and it ran really, really well. Now, there's some things about this pistol that I really like, and there's a couple of things that I think that the company could improve upon. So let me give you the things that I really like first. First of all, as you know, I really like my M&P shield. And what's interesting about that is, if you look at these two guns, they are almost identical in size. I mean, it's like the grip angle appears to be exactly the same. I mean, they're almost identical in dimensions, in width, in, you know, in just about everything. So to me, it felt very comfortable picking it up because I shoot my shield, you know, I fire my shield every week or every couple of weeks if I'm rotating in other guns that I carry. But picking up this Honor Guard pistol was like old home week. There are some things on the Honor Guard pistol that are not on the shield that I wish were there. And I got to tell you, here's a few of them. One is on the slide. I like the fact that the striations are not only on the rear of the slide, but also on the front. So, you know, different people will rack a slide differently. Some people reach over the top. Some people slingshot it. Some people, you know, grab it this way, grab it this way. It doesn't matter how you grab this slide. There's some purchase surface there for you no matter where you grab it. I really, really like that. I like the fact that the front of the slide is tapered forward a little bit. You know, it just seems to me it might be, I don't know, it might be just a little quicker and easier to holster because the front of the pistol has a taper to it. So I think that's kind of cool. Now, some other things I thought were really neat. One is the grip. I was just really impressed by the grip for a couple reasons. One, I like the way the grip is textured because the texture is comfortable but rough. It's you know, it's just enough without biting your hand, but it really grabs you. You grab it, it grabs you, and it's really comfortable, and you know you have a very solid purchase on the gun. It's also inlet where your thumb goes on both sides. This is important because if you're left-handed, you've got the inlet for your thumb on this side. If you're right-handed, you have the same inlet over here. Now, I'm very right-handed. My son is so left-handed, it's almost ridiculous. He doesn't do a lot with his right hand except hold stuff still while he's working on it with his left. So this would be a great pistol for him. It also comes with an ambidextrous mag release. So right away, the mag release is going to work on either side. Now that's brilliant if you happen to be a left-handed shooter, because I got to tell you, there aren't too many little guns like this that I've run into that are set up this way. So I was very impressed by the fact that it automatically has a mag release like that. The sights I thought were really clear. In fact, I was really surprised by them because I didn't think I was going to like them. The front sight is a very large orange dot, and the rear sight is two white dots. But I tell you, when you get them up in front of you, they just jump right out at you, and it was really easy to get them on target quickly. And I was really impressed with the sights. The other thing about the sights, I'm not sure about, but it sure looks like that I could go down to the Glock store and change out the rear sight by just getting Glock sights. It looks like they would just dovetail right in there. I could be wrong, but that's kind of the way it looks to me, and I didn't have a chance to really compare. Now, the other thing I thought was really interesting about this gun, and I'll try to get a close-up for you can see it, and that is the trigger stop behind the trigger. Now, you may know for target pistols, sometimes they'll put a screw in there, so you can run that screw out a little bit, and that will keep the trigger from over-traveling. When you press the trigger, you don't get a lot of over-travel. It'll go to the point where the pistol breaks and not much farther than that. So that's a really cool little item that they included in here. They really thought that out extremely well. So all in all, I will tell you, I like the pistol. They had kind of a rocky start where they had some issues where they weren't drop safe, but they've apparently fixed that. And if you go on their website, you'll see how they did it and what they did. So you can buy a new one, and if you drop it, it's not going to go bang on you. And if you have an old one and you're afraid of that, you can always send it to them and they'll fix it and send it back. Now, here's a couple of things I think they could improve on. One is the look of the pistol by virtue of the fact of where the serial number is, right where the slide stop is. On either side, you can see the shiny silver metal underneath. And that kind of took me back when I first looked at it. I thought, you know, that doesn't look right. It should be a darker color so it blends in with it. That has nothing to do with the function of the pistol. It just didn't look good to me. And I thought, well, you know, that I don't really like that. So I'm just sharing with you, I don't particularly like that. There may be other people that feel the same way. From a functioning perspective, one of the things I really kind of got me when I first got on the range is when you insert a magazine, you can hear it wiggle in there. It was decidedly loosey-goosey. Now, once you chamber around and the slide goes forward, it locks up a little tighter, but it's really loosey-goosey when you first insert the mag. And it's not just that mag. They're both that way. You can wiggle that one around too. And the only thing I can attribute that to is the fact that the way this locks the mag in place is on the front of the magazine here. And I think they do that so that you get that ambidextrous mag release. Now, does that affect its function? No, but it made me a little nervous because I wasn't really sure my mag was in there. I gave it a couple of tugs to make sure. So that, I think, if they could tighten that up, that would keep me from feeling a little funny about it whenever it was loaded. But functionally, it did not change the function of the pistol at all. All in all, I like it. I would say the other thing that I didn't particularly like about the pistol is that the trigger is... it's kind of gritty, so the break is gritty, and then the reset is kind of gritty. And so it feels like it's spongy at first, and then gritty when it breaks, and then it's gritty when it resets, and it's gritty when it breaks. That may settle itself out once you've put 500 or 600 rounds through it, or 1,000 rounds through it, or something. I don't know. I put about 200 or 300 rounds through it today, and it seemed to get a little better as I got closer to the end. But when you first start shooting it, it's got that grittiness in the trigger. Now, it's not a target gun. It's a self-defense gun. So, honestly, I'm not so sure that matters. But other than that, I found it to be a very pleasant gun to shoot. I'm actually very impressed. And, you know, I realize that they've had a rough go and people have been upset with them because they weren't drop safe, but they seem to be now. You know, veteran-owned company, U.S.-made gun. How can you go wrong where that's concerned? They seem to be very responsive when you talk to them and email them. I've had some email traffic going back and forth. All in all, I like it. I would say that the things that I mentioned are the only things that I would improve on it, and that would be mostly, honestly, it would be the trigger press. If you could get the trigger press a little better there on or defense, it would be a nicer pistol. But in general, I'm very pleased with it. So there you are, the Honor Defense Honor Guard. Great pistol. If you happen to be in a state where you can get one, I cannot get one in California, so I've got to give it back to Spriggs. They're going to ship it back. But I'm fairly impressed with it. And one of the things I did like about it, like as I said, is it is exactly the same dimensions as my Shield, and yet it has some other really cool stuff on it that my Shield does not. Oh, the other thing I did like about it, too, was the fact that it has kind of a little finger groove on the front of the grip. I forgot to mention that. Well, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully, I'll be able to do more of these for you from Sprague Sports. If you happen to be in Yuma, please stop on by. This is a great store and a terrific range. Thanks again for watching. Have a wonderful week, and please be safe.